co-main event.
Ladies and gentlemen,
leading up to the main event.
It's time to go.
That's going to be an amazing fight.
Kucho's toe-to-toe promotions in association with Southpaw Promotions brings fight fans four exciting rounds in professional boxing's super welterweight division. This contest is proudly sponsored by Quality Lawn Connections, Bold Financial Strategies, helping clients make smarter financial decisions, and Covering Schoonover Insurance for all of your auto, home, or business insurance needs. The referee in charge of the action when the bell rings, the veteran, Fred Corito. Introducing first, coming to us out of the blue corner, entering professional competition for the 18th time this evening. He wears the blue with triple white trim and steps into the squared circle at a trim and ready 155 pounds even. Hailing from Newberry, South Carolina, ladies and gentlemen, here is the fireman, Calvin Kindler. And standing opposite, fighting out of the red corner, is his opponent this evening. He wears the red and black trunks with white trim and officially weighed in at 152 and 1/2 pounds. His professional record stands at 4 wins against 3 defeats, with 3 of those victories registered by way of thunderous knockouts. Fighting and training out of Danville, Virginia, introducing Justin the Wolverine Hunter.
A lot of experience in this fight.
Very upright style from the fireman Kibler.
Justin immediately coming in with pressure.
Kibler being very aggressive.
Justin being nice and relaxed, picking his shots. That's going to separate the two.
I feel like Justin's going to be a little more deliberate with his blows, where Kibler is going to be just throwing. He's going to be looking to throw big.
There's a good left hook by Kibler. That's a good jab to the body. Justin's relaxed. You can hear the shots from the side. They're landing with intention, even when they're being thrown.
They're right in front of us here, and it looks like any one of those punches can drop them.
Kelvin is biting on Justin's feints. He needs to try to relax a little bit more and keep his hands up. Good two shots to the body by Justin Gunter.
Kibler trying to do a lot of head movement, I notice. He is not standing still at all.
He's getting his head over his front knee a lot, though. That's going to make
dangerous.
Him extremely susceptible for Justin's uppercuts. He's already throwing to the body. He's going to split him down the middle here soon. There he did. Beautiful body work.
We got the action right here in front of us. You can just hear Justin's power.
Justin is he's walking forward, but he's still slowing the pace down. He's fighting how he wants to fight. You see that Gunther is staying on him, but not not smothering his power. Beautiful right hand by Justin, landing flush on the nose. Yep.
He's definitely alternating the power.
Kibler knows he's in deep water, but he is giving, he's given an effort.
Great first round for Justin. It was all Justin.
All Justin. Kelvin landed some shots, but the referee came over here to get a scorecard from us. I'm not sure if we can give him one.
We got an opinion, though.
I would have to give that round to Gunther. You can see what a true road warrior Kelvin Kibler is. He came in here with no corner. He came in here actually getting cornered by a guy from Rocky Zapata's camp. That's how you know that Kelvin Kibler is here to fight.
The journeyman. Not easy to do it alone.
It isn't. It isn't. That's why you have to commend every fighter that steps into the ring. They risk their lives. Justin being nice and relaxed, picking the shots once again. Beautiful work. Clean left hook. Good right hand by Kelvin Kibler. He's trying his hardest right now.
Kelvin's leaning. He's doing a good job protecting himself.
He's smothering his power right now. See, he pulled back with that right hand and had intention. That was good. It didn't land, but it had intention. Justin's going to start throwing that right hand a little bit more consistently as Kelvin's left hand drops. Kelvin's still getting over his front foot. He needs to stay back a little bit. Good right hand by Kelvin again. Justin showing off his defense.
I can hear Justin's corner yelling at him to pressure, apply more pressure to Kelvin.
Justin has still won the round so far, but he has definitely been a little bit more relaxed.
A little reserved.
Punch pace. Yes.
He's a little reserved.
Yes. He's settling in. I suppose he's trying to pick a shot. Fatigue is showing on Kelvin as he backs up a little bit after that right hand.
He's definitely trying to lean on it a lot more.
Justin's done good work to the body. Justin rolling under countering with the right hand. Beautiful work. I would like to see him get a little bit more aggressive. I've seen Justin in the gym be extremely mean.
Definitely another round for Justin, though. I'd say easily he's got this round as well. He's up by two now.
Yes.
Please have your attention. A set of car keys have been turned in to Deputy Neal. A set of car keys. lost here. Please go over to the exit sign and see Deputy Neal. Thank you.
See in the corner of Justin Gunter, Jeff Austin wants him to throw that right hand with a little bit more intention. Like I said, he took a little bit off his punches last round and was just kind of finding his groove a little bit more, I suppose. Letting Kelvin blow off some steam, still winning the round, Gunter. Beautiful left hooks to the body by Justin Gunter. Gunter's corner yelling for him to be a little bit more physical in the pocket and pick his shots with him.
It looks like he doesn't want me to lean on him. I can hear Jeff yelling at Gunter not to have Kelvin lean on him like that.
Yeah, he wants him to push that left shoulder of his and throw that right hand afterwards. Allowing him to extend on his power, like I said in the first round.
Push
Kelvin,
him off.
Yeah, Kelvin.
Great distance.
Kelvin smothering his power when he's trying to throw those exchanges. He's landed some shots on Justin, but nothing too meaningful because he's smothering his punches.
Kelvin's fatigue is definitely showing.
Oh, yes.
He actually has some good opportunities and openings here, but he's just not able to capitalize right now. Because looks like he's almost exhausted.
Yes, the body work by Justin Gunter is definitely showing right
starting
now.
Starting to catch up to him.
Yes, it is. See, the body punches always make you, you always feel the pain, but it makes you question your heart a little bit also. Good defense by Gunter. I would like to see him get a little bit more aggressive, though. He's applying pressure, but not punching as much with intention. Once again, Justin Gunter just consistently going to the body.
Dominating the fight with punches and volume.
Nice angle.
Yeah, throws him more power
there you go. Set him up with a clean shot. He didn't see too much coming. Crowd is getting excited. They're asking for Gunter to finish. He's been a little bit more aggressive. Kelvin looks like he's on the way out almost.
Kelvin's showing nothing but heart at this point, especially as Gunter steps up the pace of his power.
Oh, yes. Still fighting. Once again, nothing but respect for both these guys. Nothing but respect.
He just survived. I think Kelvin just survived that round.
Gunter is also breathing a little heavy, so I would like to see Kelvin follow through with this last round. I believe that if he puts his hands up and tries to stay a little bit more controlled, not just throwing head over heel, you know?
Yeah. Gunter is capable of finishing this fight if he can apply the pressure and apply the power that he's just throwing at the end of that last round.
He just has to stay a little bit more consistent like he was.
Yeah. And keep some distance.
Guys, we have the main event coming up. Austin, the Native Nightmare, versus Chris, the Rocket Rollins. Actually, in 2019, I first saw my first live show in Lynchburg, Virginia. I saw Chris Rollins, the first fight of the evening, I believe. He knocked a gentleman named Stan Megaton out of the ring. Won his first boxing match by KO. Beautiful. Now we have him fighting in the main event. Kelvin's left eye a little bit swollen from that right hand of Justin's. Justin's corner asking for sharp shots, just like he's shooting right now.
Justin seems to have Kelvin right in his grasp if he just wants to unload on him.
Yes, he does. I'm not sure why Kelvin switched southpaw, but I suppose he wants to land a hard left hand. There he goes.
You called it. Going straight for it. Looks like Gunter's smiling at him, though.
Kibler still trying his hardest. This is beautiful, guys.
He's just showing a lot of heart in this fight. He had his way out multiple times over.
Beautiful body work again by Justin Gunter. I just love to see it.
Kibler is trying to show Justin that he deserves to be here.
Justin Gunter landing that right hand up top, consistently swelling the left side of Kelvin Kibler's face. I need to see Kelvin keep that left hand up a little bit more if he wants to survive. Justin shaking his head at the crowd, cheering on Kelvin.
You should be more worried about the action in the ring and trying to finish the fight.
I would love to see Justin close out the show right now. But I also love to see how durable and how much of a warrior Kelvin Kibler is. He's trying. See, his nose is bleeding, the left side of his eye is swollen, and he's still throwing. Last 10 seconds of the fight, and he knows he can't win right now, but he's still trying. Beautiful fight, guys.
That was a great fight. Much respect to both fighters.
Oh,
especially
yes.
Kelvin Kibler.
Yes. We've seen an overall great body punching by Justin Gunter to end the fight, 40-36 from my scoring points. Yeah. Both guys giving an embrace after the fight, just showing respect to each other. I appreciate it.
The referee came back for more scorecards. The fight's almost over. He'll forget.
I thought he was asking for it again, guys.
the guy to work.
While we wait for the official decision, let's go over the main event that's coming up next. The Native Nightmare, Austin Denda, is going to be going against Chris.
Deonda.
Deonda, correction, thank
yes,
you.
Yes, sir.
Versus Chris Rocket Rollin.
You know, I've seen both fighters in person fighting. I've been to all of Austin's pro fights, and I've seen most of Chris the Rocket Rollins' professional fights, also boxing.
You're talking about boxing?
Yes, boxing. I don't follow MMA as much, but I do know that Chris was extremely talented in MMA.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Chris has fought for me multiple times on the Elite Warrior Challenge. I've met Chris, I want to say it's maybe in Northern Virginia, at one of the Spartica events. Chris has been around for a long time. He's been around multiple weight classes. He held the EWC belt in two different divisions at one point. Chasing the third.
Beautiful.
The decision.
In Lynchburg, Virginia. We do scorecards. James Ensborough sees the contest 40-36, as well as Leah Jackman, 40-36. The third and final judge, Brian Pisani, scores at 39-37. All for your winner by way of unanimous decision, Justin.
Pretty much the way we expected it to go.
I'm not sure if I would have been able to give Kibler a round in that fight, but that's why I'm a fighter and not a judge.
Amen to that. Back on Chris Rollins. Yeah, he's been in the game for a long time. Chris is either all on or all off, the Chris I know. He is mainly on. A lot of heart. Doesn't give up. He pushes a pace. He's fast. He's tall, and he's long for his weight class. Chris is a formidable opponent for anybody on any given night, outside of his weight class, let alone in it. So I'm excited to see this fight. I do not know Austin very much, but I'll leave that one to you because you're his training partner.
Is there anything in the Wolverine future to clue fight fans in on when you'll be in the squared circle next?
No future opponents yet, but y'all will see me here soon or around. Look me up on Instagram or Wolverine_360. Y'all look me up and follow me there. We'll continue fighting all year. Make sure. Thank y'all for coming. Thank y'all for the support.
One more time, your winner, Wolverine, Justin Vincent.
Giving a bow to our sold-out crowd. Scott Sigmund, a phenomenal promoter. We actually sold the event out in, I believe, less than a full calendar week.
Yeah, I think he told me over the phone it was like 3 days he had the event sold out. So that's Cujo doing what Cujo does.